So previously we talked about AOQ or the average outgoing quality, and what we did in that was we took number of cases where we had a lot which has 1% defective, 2% defective, 3% defectives and so on. And based on these lots, we calculated that what will be the average outgoing quality after it passes through this sampling plan. And based on those calculations, we plotted this graph, which tells that from 1%, 2%, 3% up to 9%, what will be the average outgoing quality. Now, if you look at the peak of this is at around 2.4%, which is here, and which is slightly less than 2.5%. So this is roughly 2.4%. What does this mean is that once you use this sampling plan, and this sampling plan was selecting 80 pieces and accepting or rejecting the lot based on these 80 samples which you draw. So if you get 3 or less than 3 defectives, you accept this lot, and if you get more than 3 defectives, you reject this lot. So this was our plan. Based on that, this is the AOQ which we got out of this. And the peak of this is AOQL, which is the average outgoing quality limit. So in this particular sampling plan, the average outgoing quality limit is 2.4%. And what does that mean is, whatever quality of input which we receive, either we receive a good lot, which let's say has just 1% defectives, or let's say if we receive a lot which is very poor, and let's say that has 9% defectives. In any of these cases, our outgoing quality after this acceptance sampling plan will not be worse than 2.4% defectives. So we will not get more than 2.4% defectives, whatever input quality which we get. But the problem here would be, if we get a bad quality lot, then you need to re-inspect the whole lot and replace bad items with the new items. And that was the reason this is giving a good quality even at rejection rate such as 9%. Even at 9% defective rate, you still get a good outgoing quality, because you screen the whole lot. But the problem would be, higher defective rate lots will lead to more inspection. So this will lead us to a new term which will help us in finding out that how much inspection do we need to do if we get a good quality lot or a bad quality lot. In bad quality lot, we will have to do more inspection. In a good quality lot, we will need to do less inspection. So let's see that term on the next video.